for those of you who don't know me, I'm John Cozart. As you said, I'm running for the 51st House District against Dean Dorman. As far as I can tell, the state party hasn't invested a lot of time thinking about this race, so hopefully we can see them, show them that this is a competitive district. But I'll tell you why I decided to run. I was looking on the Secretary of State's website, and I saw that nobody had filed, and it was getting very close to the deadline. And if we're going to be one of the major two parties in the state, I think we should contest every race possible. People need to hear our message. And the platform that I plan to run on is one where every working person in Missouri deserves to earn a living wage. The workers should be given the right to collectively bargain and organize. And every student who lives in Missouri deserves the right to a quality education. And that can't happen if our state legislature underfunds their own formula by $400 million. Now, as you probably know, my opponent, Dean Dorman, when it comes to our general election matchup, you know, I'm proud to be in the same party as JFK, FDR, and I'll let him explain to you why he's in the same party as Donald Trump and Todd Akin. I believe that the most fundamental thing that's good about the Democratic Party is it has historically been the party of working men and women, and I believe it can be that party again. There's been a lot of things that have changed over the last 120 years about the Democratic platform, but as William Jennings Bryan said at the 1896 Democratic Convention, when he was given the nomination, surprisingly, he said to his Republican opponents, "You shall not crucify the working person upon your cross of gold." Thank you. I appreciate your support in November.
Thank you. It's a real pleasure to be here with you all this evening here in Saline County. I wanted to share with you how exciting it is to be a Democrat in 2016. There's a lot going on. I wanted to start tonight. I know we just have a minute or two, but with a very famous paragraph from the FFA creed. Remember when we were in FFA as freshmen, we had to memorize that, and we had speech contests involving the creed. And I looked it up this afternoon to bring it with me, and I was shocked to find out that they've modified it at least two times since I was in high school in 1968-69. But the first paragraph is so fantastic and inspirational. "I believe in the future of farming," now it's agriculture, "with a faith born not of words but of deeds, achievements won by present and past generations of agriculturalists in the promise of better days through better ways, even as the better things we now enjoy have come to us from the struggles of former years." I want to move Missouri forward in state senate and with state policy. I come to you from Higginsville, where I live with my wife on a small farm there just south of Higginsville, just a mile and a half north of the junction. There are very many important issues for our district. There's eight counties in our district. Education is very, very important. There are eight universities in our district. Farming and agriculture, sustainable agriculture, and water management are very, very important issues that are looming large for us all as farmers. And of course, jobs initiatives, helping create jobs for people to work. I'm also an attorney-trained mediator. Most of my law practice is devoted to mediating conflicts and disputes. Don't hold that against me. But we're embroiled in conflict constantly and dealing with it. If you elect me as your state senator, I'll be the first mediator ever in the state senate. It's also a privilege to precede the famous Charlie Wheeler, the mayor, former mayor of Kansas City. He was also, for those of you who can remember, was a state senator. in the Senate. And he's been a mentor and an idol for me to watch and learn. A very gifted speaker. The very first state office holder I ever met who had a JD and an MD degree both. Very, very rare in the state of Missouri. As a mediator, we help people deal with conflict in positive, constructive ways. Mediation is a voluntary settlement process of problems, conflict solving of problems. It's really the essence of democracy. And you here in Saline County represent that very well with your wide diversity of candidates for sheriff. And that's another big thing you're going to see in this year of 2016, from the national ticket all the way down to the race for sheriff. You have six candidates, very good candidates here in the primary. So it gives people choice and motivation to get out and vote and support for people that you know and trust. And I think it's going to affect the entire ticket from whoever is our Democratic head of the ticket for president all the way to sheriff in the general election. And I want to close with a story from Harry Truman, who we celebrate tonight a little bit earlier than his birthday for the Harry Truman Days and Harry Truman's birthday. But Harry Truman said a very great challenge to us as voters in 1948, which if you recall that year, he was predicted to lose as the incumbent, even by the Chicago papers. But Harry Truman said, "I want you to forget about political persuasion or political party," 1948. "Forget about that and vote for yourselves." And then he paused very dramatically and said, "And you'll end up voting Democratic." But I think Harry was a great leader. He was a winner. And I think together we will all be winners in the 21st District as well. So good luck to you. And if there's anything I can do to help you, I look forward to being your state senator. And want to support everyone here in Saline County and wish you the best of luck in 2016. Thank you.
And it is now my pleasure to introduce Dr. Charles Wheeler, former mayor of Kansas City, former state senator. As he said, has a degree in both medicine and law. Mr. Wheeler was the commencement speaker for my high school graduation. And I had the honor of meeting him again last Saturday at a function.
Thank you.
Very nice to be with you. You have here, the Wheelers have practiced
medicine in Kansas City for over 100 years. My grandfather dead, my uncle dead, and now I'm winding up a long medical practice. And my uncle had a nurse from the city, and she was a 30-year employee of his, and she lived in this town and had the same name as this town. And I'm here tonight to ask if anybody is related to that nurse or my uncle's, because she brought me here and I had a good time here. And if I go to Jeff City as your governor, I'll come back and have a good time again.